Today is a big day in Indian politics. Karnataka has voted and counting is underway. We will get to know the results in a few hours. Early leads are in. But I think it's important to first understand why Karnataka matters. This is an important election for both national parties. For the Congress, which is down to 3.5 states, it has Punjab, it has Karnataka, it has Mizoram, and it has Puducherry, which happens to be a union territory. This is a battle of survival. If Congress loses Karnataka, it will be down to its worst ever performance nationally. If it wins Karnataka, it will be a much needed boost for its morale, for the morale of its leadership as well as the cadre. Do remember that this is the first big election after Rahul Gandhi has formally taken over at the party's plenary. It will be a test of Rahul Gandhi's leadership. This election also comes a year ahead of the 2019 elections. Karnataka is an important state which gives resources to any party which wins the state. This will be an election that will give Congress confidence, it will give Congress resources, it will give Congress the courage to face the next set of state assembly elections in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Mizoram at the end of the year and then 2019. But this is an equally important election for the BJP. For the BJP, this is about consolidating its dominance. We know that over the past 2-3 years, since 2014 actually, BJP has emerged as the primary pole of Indian politics. It has almost become the hegemonic force of Indian politics. It today is in government either alone or with allies in 20 states. But the South has remained the most formidable resistant, has been most formidably resistant to the BJP's influence. As party president Amit Shah told us in an interview, if they win Karnataka, this is going to be their gateway to the South. Karnataka, the state, is extremely diverse. The Congress party introduced a move to recognize the Lingayat community and give it separate status, separate from Hinduism. This in North Karnataka will be an electoral issue in areas like Bombay Karnataka and Hyderabad Karnataka and Central Karnataka. Lingayats have traditionally been a solid vote base of the BJP. The chief ministerial face of the BJP, B.S. Yediyurappa, is from the community. Will Lingayats consolidate behind BJP or will the Congress gamble work? Look out for coastal Karnataka, which is 19 seats. This is where communal polarization is deepest. Will the polarization card of the BJP work or will there be counter consolidation and will Congress do well as well? Look out for Bangalore. Bangalore has 28 seats. Will urban Karnataka be with the BJP? We have seen in Gujarat, for instance, that even when there was rural anger, urban Gujarat remains solidly behind the BJP. Will urban areas continue to stick to the BJP in the south of the country or will we see a shift towards the Congress? Look out for the old Mysore region. This is where the BJP is actually not the most important actor. It is mostly a battle between the Congress and the Janata Dal Secular, the third force in the fray in Karnataka. If the Janata Dal Secular performs well, this is the party led by the former Prime Minister H.D. Devegowda and his sons, then what it means is that we are looking at potentially a hung house. If the Congress sweeps the region, then we may even be looking at a Congress majority. If the BJP surprisingly does well in Old Mysore, then all bets are off and the BJP could pull off a surprise and actually edge past the majority mark. So in each region, there are distinct communities, there are distinct issues, there are distinct players, and we need to watch out for all those trends in the next few hours.